What's your name, please?
Tracy Bell.
And who are you?
I am the manager at River Oaks Apartments.
And how many residents are here?
I've got 164 units.
So, what's the address here? Like, you're down by Main Street Market?
Yep.
Well, like, so you're
almost right behind Main Street Market. We're 226 Taft Court.
Okay. And some of these residents got sick, right?
They did.
And so how far are you from the river, approximately?
Approximately between 200 and 300 feet.
So everybody in there is between 200 and 300 feet that lived, 160 some people.
Yes.
Okay. So did Enbridge ever evacuate you guys?
No.
Why not? Do you know, did they tell you about the evacuation?
No.
Well, there was a mandatory 1,000-foot evacuation, and they should have evacuated everybody. Can you tell me about some of the symptoms you have or other people have had?
Myself, I have more migraines than I used to, and I've never really even thought about it. I know other people here have been really sick. Migraines, diarrhea, throwing up. I didn't talk to every resident.
Right. Did you say something about a guy had a lot of seizures after the oil spill?
Yes.
And a girl had defects with her baby?
Yes.
All right. Oh, that's horrible. What I do, people, is I question them first, and then so we can have a shorter video, and then I will know what to ask them certain questions. Well, are you mad at Enbridge? I mean, you said you went down there several times trying to get help for these people.
I went down there a lot of times to get help for these people, and they just kept sending me away, telling me no, that we didn't qualify for anything.
Didn't they pay, like, how many people did they pay?
They paid approximately 10 people here.
Out of 160, they paid 10 people.
Yes.
And why did they pick those 10 people?
I have no idea. It was a couple from certain buildings.
Wow, so they just picked and choose different people from different buildings.
Yes.
But everybody breathed this.
Right. We all breathed it.
Oh, my God.
And then I do know from the mailman that the checks were only to be delivered personally twice. And if they weren't there twice, the checks were to go back.
Well, do you know this building down here that just got evacuated, you know, right during the oil spill area or time? All those people are allowed to get money, too. And they don't even know about it. They're gone. They were, you know, they left because of mold, not because of the oil spill.
Right.
But because of that, they breathed all these chemicals in and they didn't get any paychecks.
Right.
And no medical bills, because Enbridge is supposed to pay everybody's medical bills too, because of any sickness they have from the oil spill. But Enbridge tries to say it's not their responsibility because they say that they didn't cause your health problems. I know they did, and you guys are learning they did from the MSDS sheets, but so what do you feel about all this?
Well, I'm pretty pissed off. That's how I feel. We haven't thought about it in a while, but now that you brought all this stuff to light, yeah, it pisses me off.
Well, please have anybody contact me. You have my phone number if anybody wants to fill out a health survey, and if I can get them an attorney, I'm here to help, okay?
Okay, Melissa.
And where do you live?
244 Taft Court.
And can you tell me, your baby, she had some complications when she was born?
Her side of her face was smushed. Her right eye was very puffy, and it looked like she had a black eye. And her jaw's completely offset, and one of her nostrils was closed.
And you were pregnant during the oil spill, is that correct?
Yes.
And what do you think? I mean, now that you know that the oil causes some of these symptoms, what do you feel?
I didn't really realize that it was the oil spill that would have caused something like that. I mean, at first I was very shocked by the way she looked. Because I didn't really realize, you know, I mean, I thought I had my son, he was perfect, and she wasn't. So, yeah, it's just shocking.
And there was another baby that was born about the same time that is in your building?
Yeah, he was born a few months ago, too, and he had a cleft palate. Not the cleft palate, just the He just had a pushed up lip, like a cleft palate.
Right. Yeah, I don't know if the oils caused either of these, but when you, you know, I'm going to keep investigating. If I find more babies that had problems or mothers during their birth, it just makes it's common sense when they're all having problems at mm-hmm. the same time. Well, thank you for your information, and I will try to get it out to the public so we can help others, okay?
Roger Millsap.
And Roger, you said you're really sick. You just asked to go in because you really don't feel good.
Right. I haven't felt good in a while.
You believe it's from the oil spill?
I honestly do.
And you mentioned that these people across the street were getting like $3,500 per home, and did you get anything?
Absolutely not.
Why?
And I went down and asked them, and they said because they stopped in the middle of Parrish Street was as far as they figured was eligible.
So they're saying chemicals reached these houses, but they didn't reach these houses.
Exactly.
I think that's pretty stupid.
I think that's absolutely nuts.
Now, tell me some symptoms. What is hurting you?
My lungs. I was just diagnosed with emphysema. I just told my doctor, I can't remember. Like, I was watching some videos, and it gave names of different videos, and an hour later, I couldn't remember the videos.
Right.
My memory is absolutely shot.
And you said your lungs are really bad?
Yep, I was just diagnosed with emphysema. They said I have the lungs of an 83-year-old man.
And you were fine before that?
And I was fine before that.
Yeah, it's an oil spill, sir. And, I mean, I'm trying to do what I can to help you. I'm just trying to document so I can get hundreds of people
right.
to say, you know, what's wrong with them. And maybe some people with some power will listen when we get enough people to complain.
I hope so.
Is there anything you want to tell Enbridge for not helping you, not evacuating you?
Well, I just think that it's seriously unfair that, you know, a house that's 300 foot away from me, you know, they'll do anything they can to help those guys. I'm 300 foot away.
Sir, you're only 50 foot away.
Oh, okay.
All right?
Okay. But how can they say that, you know, they can benefit those guys, they can help those guys, but anybody 50 foot more is eligible for absolutely nothing, not even medical. I mean, I went to the hospital. And Enbridge wouldn't cover nothing. I even went down and talked to Enbridge. They would cover absolutely nothing. My insurance had to cover it.
What do you want to say to them? They watch my videos.
Oh, I think that it's seriously unfair the way they're treating people. You know, it's unfortunate that they had the oil spill, but I think that they should help everyone that's involved, not just, you know, just draw a line and say, we'll help those guys and too bad for you.
So, well,
I've been here for 3 years, and, my sister's dog just died of cancer, and I know that she's on that side, and they give her benefits. And that dog was healthy as a horse until that oil spill. And the other people down here have a dog, and it's been seriously sick. I think a lot of things contribute to the oil spill.
A lot of animals have died, a lot of
right.
pets.
I bet.
And we found thousands of dead animals.
Yep.
So all the fish died, too, in 40
right.
Mile River.
Right.
Well, I'm going to try to help you out, sir, and make this video public. Thank you for your help.
Listened to Dr. Ricky Ott. And she told you that these chemicals can hurt you for years past by breathing them in. What do you think about what you heard?
Actually, it's the truth because it's been over a year. Me and my husband, we've both are still not feeling well. We're still tired all the time, and my husband's been having headaches every day. All of a sudden, we're sick, you know, sore throats and stomach problems, and he's just been having headaches every day.
And are you mad at Enbridge for not evacuating you when it happened?
Yes.
What do you think about it? Tell me.
They should have done it sooner. They should have been more respectful for us instead of themselves.
Well, they got 30, they're a billion-dollar company. And they got lots of money. They could easily throw money at you and got you out of there safely.
Yes, they could.
So they just didn't care about your health. Is
no.
that what you feel?
Yeah.
And what do you want to do about this? What are you going to do about this? Are you going to try to get in this community awareness and help out?
Yes.
Well, I hope you do, because it's important that we all stand together and fight for our health. Thank you for your interview. Can you tell me what your name is?
Richard Dufresne.
And what address are you at?
285 Parrish Street.
And you're pretty close to the oil spill, aren't you? It's right on the other side of these trees.
Exactly.
Well, tell me, I just was passing out these flyers, and you came up to me, and what did you say to me?
Well, I've pointed out this evergreen tree here. It was used to be very full and full of leaves, and it doesn't even take any wind at all, and it just starts to drop all the pine needles. So probably have to take it down before winter. Maple tree here used to be real healthy. Now I've got black spots on the leaves.
Yeah, all over the place.
Yeah, and it's never been like that before. Plus, throughout these storms, I know we've had some pretty bad storms before, but we've never had the amount of trees come down like we have this year. Probably lost about 5 or 6 trees in the backyard, and it's got to be because they've been made weak by all the chemicals and stuff in the air.
Well, didn't you say that you, some people in your family was sick?
Yeah, my wife was experiencing a little bit of memory loss. It's gotten a little better, but, and then my son actually had an episode where he looked like he was having seizures, passing out. I even took him to the ER, and they just counted it as dehydration.
Well, it's from the oil spill. It's from the chemicals. The MSDS, she says that that can happen from this, so... did they ever offer you any money?
No.
Never came here and evacuated you?
No.
What do you think about that?
That's kind of upsetting. My wife actually went down to their thing because they were doing those settlements, and they told her we were too far away. We're probably less than 800 feet from the riverbank.
Right. And, but you were breathing in, and it was a mandatory 1,000-foot evacuation. I'm mad. I mean, I don't know what you are. Your kids breathe this stuff in.
Yeah, we're actually looking to move, so.
All right, well, hopefully, you know, we can help people in the future with these videos. Thank you for your time.